Hey there, welcome to my channel. My name is Gergő and I'm excited to share everything I know about Excel, Power Query, Smartsheet and Power BI with you. So let's get started. So in my previous video, I built a Power Query friendly Excel form. I'm going to use this form to show you how you can merge multiple Excel files with multiple objects. In this form, we have tables, defined ranges, and dynamic dropdowns. I prepared a few sample files from this Power Query friendly Excel form to demonstrate the combining process in Power Query. Okay, let's combine those individual Excel files into one single table with the multiple object. In order to do that, we need to go to the Data tab again, and the left-hand side choose Get Data from File and from folder. In the folder browser, you just need to simply navigate to the folder where you save your files, select the folder and hit open. The Excel will open up the data navigator, which will read immediately the content of the folder. And for sure, it would be very simple to combine to use a built-in function. Under the bottom, it says combine, but this time we are going to manage multiple objects from these different Excel files. And instead, we are going to hit transform data and Excel will open up the query editor. We can see a lot of attributes related to our files, but we need to keep only two columns in order to transform our data. I'm going to select the content and the name column from my query table, right click, and I choose remove other column. The first column called content, that includes the actual Excel files we imported to our query table. And now we are going to use an m function to get the actual content of the Excel files and identify the different objects we have saved in those files. So we have to go to the add column on the ribbon and choose custom column. First, I have to name my column, my custom column I am going to create. Let's name it Excel content. And the m function we learned today, it's called the excel.virtual. I open the brackets and now I have to define the column on my query table, which includes the binary content of the Excel file, and that is the content column. I select the column, I close the brackets, and my function is done. Then I hit OK, and my custom column has been created. The double arrow will expand the content of these files and show us the different objects which have been saved in the file. So if I click on one of the content, then the query editor will list out the objects I have in those Excel files. So now I'm going to click on this double arrow, and from these columns I need to choose only the data, item and kind. I'm going to remove the prefix and hit OK. The kind column shows me the different type of objects I have in my files, and this time I'm looking for only a table, a specific table in my Excel files, what I want to combine together into one single Excel table. So I open up the filter and I choose table type. I hit OK. Then I see all the table objects in my Excel files. From the item column, I can see the name of the objects. From there, I'm going to select the correct table I want to combine. Let's say this time I use the usage table. I'll hit OK. Here we go. Listed out all the files with the proper content. If I go back to the data column and I select one of the cells on my query table, it will show me the actual table in my Excel file. These are the tables I want to combine with the Power Query. The next step is to expand the actual data from the Excel tables. But now I need only just the data column and the name column, which will help me to differentiate the different line items in the combined tables. So I'm going to right click on one of the columns, hit remove other columns, and from there I'm going to expand the Excel tables. The filter will list out all the available columns in the tables. I will need all of them, so I just simply hit OK, and here we go. My combined tables has been created in my query table. The last thing I may want to do is to set the proper format to each column, and in order to do that, either I select the column, I go to the home tab, and under the data type I select the proper format. This is going to be a date, or I can select the column, and at the header section you will see a format sign. Clicking on the sign, you can also set the proper format. You need to repeat the process until you set all the proper format for your table. Once you set the proper format for your table, you can decide whether you load directly to an Excel table or a pivot table, but this time I will load my data into a simple Excel table. In order to do that, I go to the home tab, I click close and load, choose close and load to table, new worksheet, hit OK. And as you see, my combined table has been created by the Power Query.